Hey, it's Becky. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm making a coin cell battery holder, my first assembled PCB product. See, I've been selling these purple coin cell battery holders in my LED sewing kit for years. They're the perfect thing for making a simple circuit, and they have a handy on-off switch so you don't have to take the battery out to take the power off of your project. Originally, I used a surface mount coin cell battery holder component only, and it happened to have these surface mount tabs with holes in them that I could sew through a couple times with conductive thread. They were not designed for this purpose, and they also didn't have that handy switch. But they were better than the through-hole variety available, since those don't have holes in the tabs at all. So there's a couple different circuits like this on the market that have just the coin cell battery clip and a single on-off switch on a PCB with tabs to connect it to the rest of your circuit, either soldering or sewing with conductive thread. The design I was using in my kit was a knockoff of a SparkFun lily pad product, and that's an open source design, so don't feel great about buying the clones, but I was looking for the best price available for my kits. So my starting point is that open source design for the sewable lily pad CR2032 coin cell battery holder, and that's what I'm making today. I used Autodesk Fusion for this project, partially because it's what I already know how to use, and because the SparkFun product files that are available for the open source design are Eagle files, which is the previous name of the software package that was rolled into Fusion. And the personal use version of Fusion is free, and it has enough features to do all the things I'm going to do today. If you want to get started making your own PCBs, you should check out my video about getting started making your first board on the DigiKey channel. It'll be out very soon if it's not out already. There, I will show you how to make your first board using Fusion, because that's what I know, and because the channel already has some great KiCad tutorials from Sean Himmel. By the way, DigiKey is the sponsor of this video, and they carry every electronics part you would ever need, including the clips and switches to populate your own circuit boards, and they have a PCB service too called DK Red. So thanks to DigiKey for their continued support of my channel. Remember, the best way to support me is to shop with my sponsors. After I got the files open in Fusion and had installed all the libraries I needed, I made a few adjustments to the design. One is that instead of having two power and two grounds, I wanted it to have three grounds and one power. This is just so that I can turn the battery connector 90 degrees and have it face that way in the circuit more easily. It's just something that annoyed me about the other one, and it's just my personal preference. So I went ahead and made that change, but it's a really pretty simple change. I didn't do a lot of design here, a lot of design work, but what I did have to do when I was uploading to JLC PCB, who's the partner for this project who made the circuit boards and populated them, was I had to pick out new components that matched the footprints of the components that were spec'd in the original open source design. So that's something where I just opened up the data sheets of the specified products and the products available to me through JLC and found ones that had the exact same spacing between their pads. So both the clip and the switch, those are the two components. Also on JLC, I set the board thickness, so I'm using a thinner than average PCB, and then also the board color. So I wanted them to be black because black goes with everything, and if I want to put it on the outside of a project so that you can see the electronics, it's just going to match better than purple. So once JLC had my board files and also my bill of materials for the parts that go on the board, then they went ahead and manufactured them. That involves making a stencil for the solder paste, applying the solder paste with the stencil, populating the board with the pick and place machine, and then running the board through a solder reflow oven. One of the things we do to make this process more efficient is by panelizing the boards, which they also did for me, to take advantage of the thickness of the machine and not just hold one of these tiny little circuit boards at a time. Then I can break them apart later. My order arrived really quickly, and I was excited to check out my first PCBA product hot off the press. I tested the battery holders by holding an LED up to them and putting battery in and testing that the switch worked. And I also tested these for longevity by leaving a battery in the holder for over a week to make sure that the pressure of the battery doesn't spring the clip loose. Sometimes that happens with less precise or lower quality clips that are the wrong dimension. They're a little bit too small, and then the spring loading puts too much pressure on maybe the less than high quality solder joints and the thing pops off. So that was an important thing I wanted to test to make sure that these were going to provide the proper quality for my customers. Now that I know I can trust these in my kits, I have swapped them out. So if you order an LED sewing kit from now on, you will get my black custom battery holders instead of the purple ones. And I have also made them available as a 2-pack standalone product in case you just want to get your hands on the battery holders. Thanks for checking them out. I'm really happy with how these came out, and thanks for following along with the journey of having them made. So whether you're just starting out in your PCB design journey, or you just want to add some LEDs to your sewing project, I hope my experience leaves you inspired to create something. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.